Okay, Dinara, you've beaten Anna Muzichuk with the black pieces today. Tell us something about the game.
Well, I'm happy about the result and overall about the game because, you know, I guess it's my first game here that I really liked. So, I mean, it was really, really good result, especially against Anna because she's a really strong player.
Have you played her before?
Oh, well, we played, one, I guess, classical game at the World Team Championship and in 2019, I guess, and also several rapid games and also maybe Blitz.
So whereabouts did you prepare this game to, roughly?
Well, I just, you know, I prepared some lines, tried to rest, went to excursion yesterday, so I guess it's worked.
Did it make you feel good, the fact you had a rest day, forget about the earlier tournament?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
Okay, let's have a look at the game.
Yeah, of course.
Okay, Dinara, let's have a look at your game from move 19.
Okay, so, I'm playing this line and I remember something from, you know, my preparation.
Yeah.
But, of course, I didn't expect today this line because, you know, sometimes it can be forced. So I thought, okay, maybe she will try something else like Italian or maybe Scottish defense. So, well, I remember that it's important to put bishop on g6 and after ba, rook a5, bishop a2. The rook f8 move is really important. I mean, otherwise, black will have some troubles.
Okay.
So, yeah, a6, queen d8, ef, king h8. And here, I guess, for white, it's better to play queen d2.
Okay.
Yeah, but...
To connect the rooks, maybe?
Yeah, sorry?
To connect the rooks, possibly?
Yeah, and there are some forced line.
Yes.
So, yeah, but after Anna played bishop d2, I thought, okay...
Bishop d2.
Well, I didn't like option with bishop f7 because I thought, okay, at the end, after maybe bishop f7, no, rook a1, queen a1, rook f7, maybe there is knight g5. And, it's slightly better for white, I guess. I'm not sure, yeah. Because, you know...
Okay.
Yeah. You can take on g5,
see.
Because rook a8 is coming,
so... A trick with queen a8 check or something? What happens?
No, it's just rook a8.
Oh, so, sorry, I couldn't see that. There's a reflection, I couldn't see the pawn on g7.
So, yeah, okay. That's why I thought that I should find something else.
So you played rook a2.
And, instead of rook a2, I didn't see any other good options for black. Yeah. Maybe something with h6, maybe something with h6 or h5,
yes.
But there is rook a6 coming, so okay, I can take on f7, then rook c6, rook a2, okay, but I wasn't sure about this position, and I thought, okay, I need to try
I think the computer flagged this move as well, with Stockfish, I think, was suggesting this.
Yeah, my pieces are doing well, I mean, I will put my bishop on d5, and then my... another bishop on c5, so it looks fine.
I think
there is enough compensation for exchange. So, you know, the rook on a6 is also located poor because, you know, I have some ideas with bishop b7 and then queen d5 is coming. So,
yes.
I thought, okay, b3 or maybe rook a1.
Yeah, because this helps to defend f2 in some
ways. Yeah, exactly. And, okay, I guess I should play bishop b5 anyway.
Yes.
And, I'm not sure about rook e3. Well, because I always have these options with bishop f2. So, I mean, I didn't calculate it very well I played rook e2, but I thought, okay, it's enough. Can't play enough compensation.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think it's okay for both players, actually, that line.
So, after rook e6, I guess it's...
Bishop d5, yes.
Yeah, it should be advantage for black, because, you know, again, you can play rook e3 because of bishop c5. Again, there is lines, I don't know.
It's very,
white can
very
do anything, because,
I will
play knight e5. And, maybe another chance was to play knight e4, but I thought it's not working, because, I guess I have bishop h4. Or, and here, maybe, sorry, maybe I should take on d4 first, sorry, instead of bishop h4, yeah. Knight d4, cd, and here bishop e3, bishop b7, exactly. Ah. Now, ah. Yeah.
Long
now
diagonal,
it's
yeah.
The best version for black, because, you know, queen d5 is coming, and, well, I don't know, it looks...
Yes.
Well,
it looks
for
overwhelming
black.
Yeah. For black. Yes.
So, yeah, but after knight e5, okay, I played bishop c5.
Yes, I think Veselin was trying to make this work, rook takes f2, and I think maybe it works
yeah.
as well.
Yeah, yeah.
The computer prefers your move.
Oh.
They're not looking it with computers, so you win that one. Okay, bishop c4.
Yeah, yeah. And knight d3 is not working because, well, I guess I can just play queen h4. And again, I have
yes.
some
yeah.
ideas with queen g3. Bishop f2 is coming, so I don't know what...
That's difficult, isn't it? Bishop
yeah.
e3, no, bishop e3 or something?
Bishop e3, I guess there is just queen h3.
Queen h3,
yeah.
Yeah,
I will take everything.
You win on, if you don't win on the black squares, you win on the white squares.
Yeah, exactly, because of this strong
yeah.
bishop, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, but rook c6 was...
Rook c6, yeah. I mean, it's already giving a huge advantage to
yeah,
black.
Yeah, because I guess I can also play queen h4 here. I'm not
yes.
sure which
yes.
one better. Maybe rook f2. But
yeah,
well,
I think
sure.
Veselin wanted to play queen h4.
Oh.
And you played a different move, and yours is just
yeah.
as good. Okay.
Bishop f2. Okay, king h2. Okay, I can take on c6. I can guess I take on e1 first, but I thought that queen h4 maybe will be faster.
Yeah.
Because after knight f7, of course, I will not take
yes.
my rook, and I can just play queen g8, even, I guess, bishop f7.
Yes.
But I thought that king g8 is a better one. Mm-hmm.
There were some nice lines if white doesn't play knight f7 check.
Yeah.
I suppose rook e3 or bishop, and you just play bishop g3
bishop
check.
Bishop g3, exactly, and then, yeah, rook f2 is coming.
So you get rid of the bishop and
yeah,
then
yeah.
give checkmate. So it's a very nice finish in that
Thank
game.
You.
Well played.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.